What's up, Star Wars fans? My name is Prince, and I'm an urban acolyte. Now, I want to say thanks for showing me love on the two most recent videos about these rumors on Star Wars Leaks Reddit board and the rumors that Jason Ward dropped on making Star Wars about Palpatine's Sith fleet, the Sith troopers, and a possible connection to the Knights of Ren. Now, just looking at the comments section, I felt like I need to post a video talking about Palpatine's contingency plan. Now, it's not really clear what Palpatine's plans were, because I'm sure there's something that will be revealed in the Rise of Skywalker when Palpatine officially makes his return, but I wanted to shoot a video to talk about what I know right now. Hey, if you're new here, I talk about Star Wars on this channel, but I also post videos about the MCU and the DCEU movies, and I help promote martial arts films with Well Go USA, but I also want to talk about other martial arts movies and TV shows too. So you can be on the lookout for my coverage of the Woo Warriors series coming to Netflix next week. Also, a big part of the channel is not just talking about Star Wars, but showing people how Star Wars influenced me to get into martial arts, meditation, and fitness. So right now, I'm putting together a brand new program that will start on August the 5th. I'm looking for folks looking to lose at least 10 pounds in the next 60 days and get in shape as we get ready for the Rise of Skywalker that's coming in December. Now I'm looking for 5 people to test it out at a huge discount. Help me work out the kinks and get some amazing results that I can use as a case study. So if that's you, I need you to do 2 things. First, comment, tell me more down in the comments. And then I need you to reach out to me on Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook, because look, I cannot contact you through YouTube. And if you don't do the social media thing, then email me at info@urbanacolyte.com and I'll discuss the details with you. But okay, let's talk about Palpatine's contingency plan. So after the second Death Star went kaboom over the forest moon of Endor in Return of the Jedi, we saw Palpatine's contingency come into play in the story mode for Star Wars Battlefront II and in that 3-part comic book series that featured Poe Dameron's parents, Kes Dameron and Shara Bay. Now, Operation Cinder kicked everything off where these satellites that could control the weather basically tried to destroy Naboo, which was Palpatine's homeworld. Now, Palpatine also ordered members of Inferno Squadron to destroy some of his observatories where he'd been storing Jedi and Sith relics. Now, we officially got the downlow on Palpatine's contingency plan in Chuck Wendig's Aftermath trilogy, and the plans began decades before the Clone Wars. Palpatine traveled to the planet Jakku, where he began the construction of his observatory on Jakku, and he met an orphan by the name of Gallius Rax, who was supposed to be instrumental in leading the Imperial Fleet into the unknown regions of space where Palpatine had been sending scout ships and research teams to explore and seek out the dark side presence that Palpatine sensed out there. Now, Palpatine believed that the source of the dark side of the Force came from out beyond the unknown regions of space. And I'm curious as to how this will relate to the secrets that he learned from his master, Darth Plagueis. Now, see, what many Darth Plagueis fanboys say is based on non-canon stuff from either the Plagueis novel or how they misinterpret what Palpatine said to Anakin in Revenge of the Sith about his dead master. Now, Plagueis, like all Sith lords, are obsessed with physical immortality. Yes, the Bane Order of Sith dictates that a master raises their apprentice to eventually succeed them in order to strengthen the line of the Sith. But the truth is, no Sith lord actually wants to die and relinquish their power. Plagueis actually discovered the key to immortality, and it wasn't the key to saving the people you love. Not really. This was a lie that Palpatine told Anakin because that's what Anakin wanted to hear. See, this is the thing about the dark side. The dark side will tell you exactly what you want to hear, and it's usually true from a certain point of view. So you're probably saying to yourself, Prince, you just contradicted yourself, homie. You said Palpatine lied to Anakin, but then you said that the dark side tells the truth. See, the final secret of the dark side is that when someone realizes the full potential of the dark side, they basically become like a god. The closest thing we've seen in Star Wars are the ones on Mortis. With the full power of the dark side, someone can reshape reality as they see fit. And you can read this from Palpatine in the Tarkin novel. In Anakin's case, with that power, he could save the ones he loves. So Plagueis discovered that secret and he wanted to use it to become immortal. Palpatine wanted to use it to gain ultimate power, take revenge against the Jedi Order, and establish himself as ruler of basically an eternal empire. So when Plagueis taught this secret to his apprentice, Palpatine killed his master in true Sith fashion. Plagueis died before he could realize the full power of the dark side, and now he's dead. Now, it is probably the case that Palpatine's actions to unleash the full power of the dark side sent ripples through the Force, and as Plagueis always said, the Force will always find a way to balance the scales. It'll always strike back. Palpatine's actions are what caused the time of prophecies to come into play. You will understand that statement if you've read Master and Apprentice. The time of the prophecies means that the birth of the Chosen One, Anakin Skywalker, was at hand. So Palpatine is not Anakin's father, and he did not create Anakin. His actions brought about a number of events, like the appearance of the Kyber crystal that is not Kyber, which would indicate that the time of the Chosen One was at hand. Now, sorry to the folks who misinterpreted that panel in Vader number 25, but Palpatine is not Anakin's father, and he did not create Anakin. He indirectly caused Anakin to be conceived by the midichlorians. So it's possible that Palpatine discovered an unnatural way to preserve his consciousness beyond death. Yuk Tashu mentioned some of the unnatural abilities of the dark side, such as a force drain ability where masters of the dark side of the force can drain the force from living beings in order to lengthen their own lifespans. Did Palpatine use force drain to somehow manage to preserve his own life? Maybe the amount of death and destruction when the second Death Star was destroyed created some opportunity for Palpatine to make himself strong enough to become some kind of disembodied spirit. I mean, think about what Chirrut Imwe said in Rogue One. The Force moves darkly near a creature that's about to kill. With all the death and destruction going on during the destruction of the second Death Star, maybe it presented the perfect opportunity for Darth Sidious to leech off the dark side of the Force before it could return to the Source in order to preserve his own life. Now, that's just a loose theory, and y'all heard it here first, folks. Maybe I'll have to devote a video just to explain that idea. But anyway, I'm saying all of this because, according to Yuk Tashu, Palpatine was going to return, as in he would be resurrected. Yuk Tashu mentioned Palpatine's return in the first Aftermath novel with the politicians and the military leaders who would go on to be the first generation leaders of the First Order. Now, in the second Aftermath novel, Life Debt, I think Yuk Tashu was actually practicing the ritual. At the time, he was being held on Chandrila, and he was basically writing some Sith incantation on the wall, basically in his poop, and he was speaking incoherently. Now, on Palpatine's observatory on Jakku, there may have been some well of power that went all the way down to the planetary core of Jakku. Yuk Tashu was attempting to perform a ritual that he claimed would resurrect Palpatine, but he was killed by Gallius Rax. So what I believe Palpatine's contingency plan was supposed to be involved destroying anything that might uncover his identity or his plans in the event that the Jedi managed to return. More importantly, he needed to cover up anything that revealed his true identity as the Dark Lord of the Sith. Now, I believe Palpatine instructed Yuk Tashu to find followers of the Sith religion, which became the acolytes of the Beyond. Maybe the name involved this threat from the Beyond that's being mentioned in various Episode 9 rumors. Like, these are the acolytes devoted to what Palpatine believed to be the source of the dark side, beyond the unknown regions. Also, with followers devoted to the dark side, it made it easier for Palpatine to possibly identify a new apprentice. I believe the Knights of Ren are actually Force-sensitive members of the Acolytes of the Beyond, but this is just a hypothesis that I've held going all the way back to 2016 when this whole thing kicked off. Palpatine's plans were, much like in Return of the Jedi at the Battle of Endor, to draw the Rebel fleet into a big fight in this case at Jakku, where the Empire would make its last stand. This would actually be a ruse where the planet Jakku would be destroyed along with the Rebel fleet when some kind of gravity well would be activated, basically causing the planet to implode and pulling the Rebel fleet down with it. The Imperial fleet would then follow the orders of Gallius Rax, what he was given, to lead the fleet into the unknown regions of space, where whatever Palpatine had been working on for the last 30 years or more, meaning from the time he began sending scout teams into the unknown regions up to about a year after the Battle of Endor, then he would find those resources. Somehow they would bring back Palpatine or find a resurrected Palpatine who was already out there and return to establish a new empire. Now, with Luke Skywalker potentially out of the way and the Rebel forces defeated, Palpatine could identify a new apprentice and perform the ritual, allowing him to unleash the full powers of the dark side, or he'd be free to explore the unknown regions to find whatever it is that he sensed from out there. That's what I think Palpatine's contingency plan was. It wasn't the First Order. See, what had happened was Gallius Rax became greedy. Instead of following Palpatine's orders, he decided to establish himself as the new emperor. Gallius Rax killed Yup Tashu, and this left the acolytes of the Beyond with no leadership. So who knows what happened to them? But I still think the Knights of Ren grew out of the acolytes. I mean, the last time we saw the acolytes of the Beyond, they were on a planet not far from where there was a satellite Jedi temple that Luke Skywalker had visited. Now, the First Order went into the unknown regions, but without anyone Force-sensitive to navigate those unstable hyperspace lanes out there, they got lost and they nearly died. Snoke found them and he saved the First Order fleet, and he eventually became their leader. Snoke discovered Palpatine's plans and his true identity as Darth Sidious, Dark Lord of the Sith, but he decided to take what the First Order built and promote his own agenda. Now, if Snoke knew all of Palpatine's secrets, it is possible that Snoke knew about a Sith fleet. Snoke knew about the Knights of Ren, and he worked with the Knights of Ren when they had a shared agenda. But the Knights of Ren were never part of the First Order, as we initially believed, or at least I did at first. I'm going to admit that. But who knows? Maybe Kylo Ren was a double agent, as people said all along. And listen to me closely. Don't get it twisted. Because he's not working for the Resistance or the Jedi. He would be working for the First Order and the Knights of Ren and possibly the Sith, whether knowingly or unknowingly. I mean, personally, I think Kylo Ren knows that the Knights of Ren are tied to the Sith. Maybe they aren't Sith as in they are not Sith lords, but they follow the dark side and the Sith religion. And it makes a lot of sense when you think about it. I mean, what would hurt Luke and his parents more than anything than knowing that not only did their son fall to the dark side, but he tried to join the Sith the best way he could. Oh, and on top of that, he's going to join the First Order too. So maybe he was some type of double agent providing intel to the Knights of Ren and the Sith fleet. I mean, the First Order Star Destroyers have weapons powered by kyber crystals based on Death Star technology, and the Sith fleet appears to have Star Destroyers armed with the same weapon as the Death Star, or possibly a bigger super weapon like Starkiller Base, which was something in the concept art for The Force Awakens. At one point in time, Starkiller Base was going to be a super Star Destroyer or Snoke Supremacy with like this Death Star-like orb in the center of it. So basically, Palpatine's plan was fractured, but there appears to be this other faction we never really knew existed that was working in the shadows that appears to have been carrying out Palpatine's plans while we've been focused on the First Order and arguing over these stupid Snoke theories for the last 3 years. But anyway, hey, those are my thoughts. Like I said at the beginning, we'll never really know what Palpatine's contingency plan is until it's eventually revealed in Episode 9. Or maybe more things get released heading into the movie before December. For now, we'll just have to wait and see. What do you guys think about all of this? I mean, it's pretty crazy and it might be a lot to take in. So maybe you should go back, flip back and reverse it and watch this video a few more times. But anyway, hey, let me know your thoughts in the comments below and I'll be checking back to see what you all have to say. And also, do not forget about this Jedi program training program I'm putting together. Hey, let me know in the comments if you're interested, but you really need to DM me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter for more details. And when you hit me in the DM, say, tell me more. And I'm going to be honest with y'all, man. I set five people, but two of those spots are already taken. And my main man, Rodney Brown, is probably going to take the next one, the third slot in the next hour. So, hey, if you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and click that subscribe button so that you can take your first steps towards becoming an urban acolyte. Embark on the journey to become the hero of your own story and become a force for change in your community. If you like this video and you want to see more, be sure to check out these videos on the top theories for Star Wars Episode 9. You can also check out this other video that YouTube has picked just for you. But anyway, hey, that's all I got for this video, so thanks for watching. Y'all keep on breathing, and may the force of others be with you always.